you to Rachael's father, who's going to give you a wonderful speech now.
No pressure.
Rob will be giving a speech.
Not so well.
And then I shall be finishing that off. So over to you, Phil. Hello, everybody.
Hello, Phil.
Right, I've been introduced, but anyway, for those who don't know me, and most of you, at least half of you do, I'm the father of 50% of why you're here today. Phil, or specifically Rachel's dad. That was the first bit, I learned that. I can't remember it. I did actually pay to have someone do a speech for me, but my older brother John has got the same duty to perform in a couple of months' time, so I thought it'd be unfair to set the bar too high. So I'd like to thank you all for coming, particularly those who travelled a long way. Very much appreciate it. And especially like to thank Stephen Val, who in a short time was owning them, made us feel very welcome. And thank you for that. I'd also like at this time thank my wife for being with me today and being always at my side to help Rachael through life. I'm also looking forward to next year when, barring any major catastrophes, me and Steve should be able to have some friendly football banter when Norwich get promoted into the.
Yes, 4-1
today, thank you. The next bit is easier for me, and it's probably the most personal bit. I've been blessed to have Rachael. She's very beautiful, and she's very intelligent and clever. And while she's always been my little girl, in the last few years she seems to have come on in leaps and bounds. She's secured herself a nice job, and with Rob, they've bought themselves a lovely house, which they should both be very proud of. I think it's probably fair to say that Rachael was a bit apprehensive about what I was going to say today. I can be a tad undiplomatic, and sometimes a bit tactful. My jokes aren't always good taste.
The right colour.
But today is not a day for that. Today is a day to say, Rachael, you really made me proud, and I'd like to thank you. Now the hard bit, but in a way it's not harder, because I'd like to say about Rob. We've known Rob for a few years now, and we first met Rob on the high street in Leicester, and I have to say I was quite impressed. Unfortunately, at that time I was in need of a shave and probably a haircut, so I'm not sure Rob was quite the same mind. Anyway, since that first meeting, we've had a lot of talk with Rob, and he's been around and done things together. We found him very helpful. I've been poorly lately, so I've had to go to hospital quite a lot, and Rob's always been there to take me, so I can't thank him enough for that. And he's never been, oh, I can't do that, there's anything wrong, he's always done it, so a personal thank you as well on that one. Yeah, Rachel's my girl. I love her very much, but I can think of no one who I would not want to take on that responsibility. Thank you for that. So, Marguerite and I would like to wish you both happiness. And I thought I'd pass on a little bit of wisdom, though they might not. Rachel, musicals aren't everything.
Yes, they are.
And they're never going to be as good as Guns N' Roses. And Rob, Alan Partridge is not a good Rob. Right, nearly there. Approximately 32 years and 240 days ago, I made another speech as the groom on my wedding day. On that day, I thanked my wife for making it the best day of my life. But I'd like to say, welcome, Rach. This comes a very close second. anyway, enough of my waffling. I'm going to propose a toast in a minute, but I noticed in the paper this morning, if anyone wanted an inspiration for a horse in the National today, there's a horse called Live, Love and Laugh. And I think that's a pretty inspirational sort of name for today. So if anyone's got any phones in, I'll put bet on, I'll go for that. And I think it was 50-1 last time. So, please be upstanding.
Mother Rachael.